আমার ঘর আমার স্কুল ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্টস হোপ ইউ আর ওয়েল অ্যান্ড স্টেইং অ্যাট হোম নাও উই আর গোয়িং থ্রু এ ক্রাইসিস মোমেন্ট অ্যান্ড আই থিঙ্ক ইউ অল আর মেইনটেইনিং দ্য সেফটি মেজার্স রিগার্ডিং কোভিড নাইন্টিন দ্যাট ইজ ইউ অল আর ক্লিনিং ইউর হ্যান্ডস উইথ সোপ রেগুলারলি You are maintaining coughing courtesy and you also are avoiding all public places or public gathering. Now, I am Bonani Rani Bishwas, assistant teacher, Bagehat Government Girls High School. Today, I am going to take classes of class 9, English first paper. Today we are going to learn Unit 5, Lesson 2. Now dear students, our today's learning outcomes. By the end of the lesson, the students will be able to comprehend the text, answer questions and complete a table. Now, dear students, look at the pictures and try to guess what the pictures signify. Can you guess or do you see in our first picture? In our first picture, we see traffic jam. And in the second picture, we see a dumping place. And in the third picture, we see a dying river full of waste materials. And the fourth picture shows a deep cleanse where a smoke comes. So can you guess our today's lesson? Our today's lesson is about environmental pollution. Do you have any idea about environmental pollution? I think you have already understood it from our picture. And can you mention some of the names of environmental pollution? Yes, you are right. Air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, and finally, odor pollution. Do you know the meaning of odor? Odor means smells. When you come to your school very often, in the roads, you have this experience of odor pollution. Now, we are going to learn about environmental pollution. At first, I am giving you some important vocabulary. It is grip. Grip means grasp. You can see the image of grip in the picture. And exhaust. Exhaust is waste gases or steam, etc. that are released from an engine or a machine, especially from a vehicle. You can see the image of exhausts in our picture. Now, other important words that you will find in the text are indiscriminate. This is an adjective. Indiscriminate means acting without careful judgment, or you can say without proper planning. In Bangla also you can say nirbichar. In Bangla, what you can say? Nirbichar. Then the word hazardous. This is also an adjective word. It means risky. And you know what is risky. Then comes reservoirs. Do you have any idea about reservoirs? Yes. A natural or artificial lake used as a source of or a store of water. Then comes the word toxic. Yes. Toxic means poisonous. And yes, this is also an adjective word. And enormous. Enormous. Do you know the meaning? Enormous? Yes, it is huge or immense or very large. Now, dear students, today we will learn about environmental pollution and you open page 59. Open page 59. Now let us see it. Bangladesh is now in the grip of all sorts of pollution like air pollution, soil pollution and water pollution. You are also familiar with these words. You very often heard this. The dwellers of the urban areas are the worst sufferers of such pollution. So people of urban areas are worse sufferers than people of village areas. The indiscriminate industrialization process in Bangladesh over the past decades has created significant environmental problems. We are industrially developed, and this is the main reason of this environmental pollution. We will now read about some of the most common types of environmental pollutions and ways of coping with them. Now, can you tell me the regions of air pollution? Yes, you are right, a smoke or exhausts. We have already seen the image of exhausts. Then a smoke, from where it comes from? A smoke or poisonous exhaust comes from industrial plants, from bleak cleans, or old or poorly serviced vehicles. Then dust. You also know dust is also responsible for air pollution, and dust comes from roads and construction sites. Where there are many construction sites, or when we come through roads, we very often experience dust. Then now we'll read about air pollution. Air pollution comes from a wide variety of sources. In Bangladesh, poisonous exhausts from industrial plants, big cleans, old or poorly serviced vehicles, and dust from roads and construction sites are some of the major sources of air pollution. We can minimize this type of pollution by making less use of motor vehicles and avoiding the use of vehicles older than 20 years. So you already are experiencing that because of this lockdown, now the air of Dhaka city is getting fresh. So this is the region, the vehicle, enormous number of vehicles are responsible for this air pollution. We may also use proper lubricants to lessen the level of emission and plants. That is, we have to use pure oil. That means lubricants to minimize the emission of plants. We can also encourage people to use compressed natural gas, that means CNG, or liquid petroleum gas, LPG, for fueling their cars. The government may relocate hazardous industries like brick kilns to areas away from human habitations. That is, government can take initiatives to shift our hazardous industries to remote places where people do not live. Then we can minimize air pollution. Now we will learn about water pollution. Can you mention the regions of water pollution? Yes, that is erosion and waste disposal near water bodies. We very often throw waste here and there. We throw waste into drain, then it ultimately flows into rivers or canals and pollutes our water. Now we will learn about water pollution. Water pollution can occur in oceans, rivers, lakes, ponds, and underground reservoirs. As different water sources flow together, we know that water sources are interlinked. Water from river or canal goes to the sea. So, as all different water sources flow together, the pollution can spread easily and quickly. Causes of water pollution include increased sediment from soil, erosion, improper waste disposal and littering, leakage of soil pollution into water supplies, organic materials that decay in water supplies. In fact, polluting the land means polluting the water. Throwing away a toxic substance on the ground
near a water source means it eventually reaches the body of water. When we throw any kind of wastes, it ultimately goes into drain and then goes to river. Thus, we ourselves are polluting our water. As a result, the water is polluted. Industrial wastes must not be disposed in rivers or lakes. We need to be more careful about disposing household wastes too. Use of pesticides means that when it rains, chemicals used in the lawn or garden wash into the water bodies. Therefore, we must be aware of the dangers of using pesticides as they may pollute our rivers, canals and lakes. Now, dear students, we have learned about water pollution. Now, we will learn about soil pollution. Can you mention the causes of soil pollution? Yes. Enormous volume of industrial waste and household waste. We already have learned from water pollution that water pollution and soil pollution are interrelated. That means industrial waste, household wastes, polluted soil and water simultaneously. And other sources of soil pollution, you know, polythene shopping bags or plastic, both also causes soil pollution. Then agricultural pesticides and fertilizers also pollute soil. It also pollute water. Now we'll learn about soil pollution. Among the most significant causes of soil pollution is the volume of industrial waste, which is being produced every day but not disposed properly. The mismanagement of household wastes, particularly the polythene shopping bags, has caused serious threat to the soil and the drainage system. Another cause for soil pollution is the use of agricultural pesticides, fertilizer, etc. Sometimes fuel leakage from automobiles may get waste away by rain and seep into the nearby soil. Pesticides and fertilizers are useful for plant growth, but their overuse has led to soil pollution. Natural fertilizers and compost can be used instead of their chemical alternatives. So we can use cow dung or instead of chemical fertilizers. Recycling is another way to reduce and control soil pollution. Recycling papers, plastics and other materials reduces the volume of refuse in landfills. Deforestation also causes erosion, pollution and the loss of fertility in the topsoil. Planting trees and reforestation help prevent soil erosion and plant. So what we have to do, we have to plant more and more trees to prevent all these types of pollution. And we also have to be careful about disposing our wastes. Then we can minimize all types of pollution. Now, dear student, complete is blank with no more than two words. You see, three sections: pollution, there is air pollution and soil pollution. Then there is causes and suggestions. Causes: toxic smokes from plants, vehicles which are old and poorly dashed, a smoke from the dash pits, industrial wastes not dashed properly, use of dash shopping bags, use of agricultural pesticides and dash. Then suggestions, what will be the suggestions? Don't drive motor cars which are older than dash years. Use car lubricants of good quality to keep the dash level minimum. Use CNG or LP dash as car dash. Use compost for agricultural purpose. Dash paper, plastics,
and other materials. Plant more trees to help prevent loss of fertility in the dash. Dear students, now fill in the blanks. And I think you have already done it from your above text. And now, match your answer with me. Toxic smoke from industrial plants, vehicles which are old and poorly serviced, a smoke from the brick fields. Suggestions. Suggestions, you see suggestions. Regarding air pollution, what can we do to minimize air pollution? Don't drive motor cars which are older than 20 years. Use car lubricants of good quality to keep the emission level minimum. Then, so what we will also do? Use CNG or LP gas as car fuel. About soil pollution, the causes of soil pollution. Industrial waste not disposed properly. Use of polythene shopping bags. Use of agricultural pesticides and chemical fertilizers. And suggestions for soil pollution. Use compost for agricultural purposes. Recycling paper, plastics and other materials. And plant more trees to help prevent loss of fertility in the soil. Now, dear students, I think you have understood the text clearly. Now, I'll give you a homework. Give you a homework. Your homework is a paragraph on environment pollution. Okay? When you will come to, you will do your homework at home. And when we will go to your school again, you will show it to your teacher. Now, what we have learned today? We have learned about environmental pollution, the causes of different kinds of pollution, and how we can minimize it. Actually, we ourselves are mainly responsible for all these types of pollution. We should be careful about our environment to save ourselves. Otherwise, our life will be at a stake. Because of environmental pollution, we are suffering from different kinds of airborne and waterborne diseases, you know. That is bronchitis and other respiratory diseases, and from cholera, diarrhea are waterborne diseases. So, dear students, you all should be careful about pollution, and you also will make people around you to be careful about our environment, and we all will remain safe. Thank you everybody. Stay at home and be safe.